I made an experiment. I asked ChatGPT to read 1,000 Reddit posts about ChatGPT. I made a small experiment to show an example of how AI can change journalism. If I ask you to think about AI and journalism, I reckon there's a good chance you're picturing journalists being replaced by machines and an internet full of content generated by AI. I'm going to talk about these risks, but I also want to talk about the new types of journalism that became possible with AI. I'll show you how I programmed my experiment and the result, but first, I want to talk about how AI is already changing journalism. In a newsroom, the first step for journalists is to find out what they're going to write about. AI is changing journalism already at this stage. Algorithms can sift through all the noise and help journalists find trends, events, and anomalies. Take the example of Reuters. In 2016, they developed a machine learning algorithm that automatically detects events on Twitter by the minute. When an earthquake broke out in Ecuador in 2017, they claimed their journalists had a head start of 18 minutes over other news organizations to report on the situation. After the idea comes research. This is where things get interesting for me. AI opens doors to a whole new way of doing things. We're starting to see quite a few algorithms that are able to detect fake news and images, and the most interesting for me, AI allows journalists to analyze data at a scale that simply wasn't possible before. Take this crime map made by Stuttgarter Zeitung, a German newspaper. They made a machine learning algorithm that is able to understand police communications in Stuttgart and recognize where incidents took place. They then show these incidents in a crime map. La Nación, an Argentine newspaper, used AI to monitor the transparency of the elections. They used computer vision to validate the telegrams at the polling stations and prevent fraud. BuzzFeed used AI to analyze flight tracking data and search for hidden spy planes. They wrote a story on how US law enforcement were using small aircraft to observe points of interest in US cities. The way we produce content is also changing as AI becomes capable of making content itself. For example, the Associated Press uses AI to generate tech stories to make sports previews, game recaps, and to report on earnings for publicly traded companies. This opens up the discussion on the scenario where we end up with journalists losing their jobs as their work is automated, and the risk of the internet becoming flooded with content generated by AI. However, there's also the other side of the coin. This AI allowed the Associated Press to report on 10 times more companies. So, you see, in this case it didn't necessarily replace jobs. It might have allowed the same number of journalists to become 10 times more productive. AI has the potential to automate repetitive tasks and to allow journalists to spend their time on the investigative work that really matters. There are some other risks. AI can be biased or simply make mistakes, which can lead to misinformation. And there are some forms of automatic content that aren't exactly well received by everyone. This is a news anchor of Kuwait News. She's also not real. There is an increasing number of AI tools that are able to turn text into video and sound in whatever languages you want. You just write text and AI does the rest. However, I have the feeling that in Western countries, this type of journalism will not be easily accepted by the public, at least not in the near future. Then comes the publication stage. Here, AI can be used to make recommendations to the audience, create various versions of the same content, and add subtitles. For example, the subtitles of this video were made with the help of YouTube's AI, and AI probably recommended this video to you in the first place. And of course, there are risks here. AI learns to show you what you like. A recommendation system that only shows you what you like can lead to information bubbles where you only see information from people with the same opinion as yours. This can lead to polarization and extremism. Finally, AI can also help with managing feedback from the public and archiving information. Now we get back to our ChatGPT experiment. In the past couple of years, we've seen language models like ChatGPT improve significantly. This experiment is an example of how I can see this technology being used in the future to process data in investigative journalism. I want to show you how I was able to summarize over 1,000 Reddit posts about a topic with ChatGPT. I didn't know what topic to choose, so I chose ChatGPT itself. I made a simple algorithm with two steps. Step 1, get the post from Reddit. I used their open API for this, and I got the top 250 most relevant posts on all subreddits. And then I repeated the search for the 4 subreddits which I thought were the most relevant. Step 2, summarize the post with ChatGPT. I used the API from OpenAI, which has a limit of about 1,000 words. That means I had to do this in phases. First, I asked ChatGPT to summarize the posts one by one. This gives us about 1,000 summaries. Then, I asked ChatGPT to summarize the summaries. I joined the summaries into groups and I kept summarizing them until I ended up with one final summary. This was the final result. It says ChatGPT received mixed reactions from Reddit users. Some users found it helpful, others criticized its accuracy and potential for misuse. It also mentions concerns about bias and offensive messages generated by ChatGPT and questions about the costs of fine-tuning the model and the security of conversations. Some users also talked about how we should be cautious about blindly trusting ChatGPT. And finally, there were discussions about the exaggeration of its impact and the need for regulation. Let's say that I wanted to do this manually. If we assume it takes an average of 2 minutes to read and summarize each post, then I would have to spend 40 hours doing this. With AI, I just had to run the code. If you want to see what Reddit thinks about a certain topic, feel free to use the code. The link is in the description. AI brings both risks and opportunities to journalism. I think we're going to see an increase in data journalism content in the next few years. And that's what this channel is about. I try to use data science to tell stories from a different angle than traditional journalism. If there's a topic you'd like to see explained with data, let me know in the comments. I read every comment. If you want to support my work, consider leaving a like and subscribing to the channel. And thank you to our patrons.